adjusting improperly. They didn't understand what they were doing. A starlight scope doesn't measure energy. It only amplifies photons. They were using a radiac meter in an improper way that was used for field measurements and not for point sources. I have actually walked the ground there. I have taken a very specific Geiger counter to measure the area. There's nothing above background
radiation.
All right,
let him respond, Chuck.
Well, first of all, have you ever seen a lighthouse move through the forest, Larry? Horizontally, approach you, recede from you, explode into five white objects, send down an equivalent of a laser beam, and do so into the weapon storage area? And I would defy anybody to take a police car into the woods. When Jim went out, he took a Jeep and he had to dismount because he couldn't go any further.
Do you think he's lying, James?
No, I think they're just misinterpreting what they saw that night. There were numerous lights out there that night. Let's put it this way. Where would it have been best to have viewed this object that night? It would have been best viewed from the Woodbridge Tower. I interviewed the people that were in the tower that night. They saw nothing. They heard nothing. There was nothing on radar.
The sergeant says it wasn't manned.
It wasn't manned that night. The tower was empty.
The ATC, the tower was manned that night, and the ATC facilities did have control that night. The British radar also saw nothing that night.
Let me get a break, and we'll come back with more. James will stay with us. We'll also ask him to talk to Callahan about that Tokyo plane incident. You're watching Larry King Live. Let's check in with Anderson.
For a UFO.
Well, I was the district governor of 56 Lions clubs in southwest Georgia, and I had to visit all the Lions clubs and make a speech. And I was outside a school lunchroom one night right before sundown. It was getting dark, and we were getting ready to eat supper. And I and about 25 men were standing around, and all of a sudden in the western sky, we saw a strange light coming toward us, a round light, and it got closer and closer, and right above the pine trees, it stopped, and then it began to change colors from blue to red to white. And then it stayed there for a while. We were all aghast. We didn't know what it was. And then it just disappeared into the west. That was the end of it. So it was a genuine UFO in that it was an unidentified flying object, but I have never thought and still don't think that it's possible for, you know, creatures from Mars to come here and visit us and go back home.
Before we have Jim McGahey respond to the story of that Japanese pilot and what he saw from his Japan air cargo jet, Sergeant Peniston wants to respond to something that James said.
You know, thank you, Larry. It's just, I respect James for his opinion on that, but if I was in his position right now, looking at us and looking at this story, I'd probably have a lot of doubt about it, too. But this is not about lights in the sky. This is about an object that has landed in a woods and was investigated by a team of experts that are familiar with aircraft identification and that, and there's just no way in the world that this could be anything other than it was a physical craft.
All right, Jim, he's saying he touched the object, he surrounded the object, and the object took off and went into space. That's either a madman.
Well, there's no evidence of that. I've never seen any evidence.
So then you say he's lying.
His report. No, I'm saying he may truly believe that he touched an aircraft.
That also
something
flew.
Called confabulation, but the question is there any evidence other than his anecdotal story, his report, that anything occurred? And there isn't. There simply is no evidence. I would like to respond to something about Colonel Halt talking about the idea that the Air Force never contacted him or investigated him, this incident. Since the closing of Blue Book in 1969, it has been official United States Air Force policy not to take a UFO report, pro, con, negative, or any otherwise. It
Why?
Actually is, well, because it caused a great deal of bad publicity for the United States Air Force, and they didn't want to be involved with it. So the official policy is if someone calls up the Air Force about a UFO, they simply say, they refer the people to local law enforcement agencies without comment.
There's another area I want to cover, and we've got John Callahan been standing by, but you want to say something quickly?
Let's say one thing. Are you aware that the OSI did investigate this?
I am aware that the OSI investigated it. Of course, the OSI, of course, looks into anything very often that security police do, and I don't want to get into why that is.
What do you think, Jim, of the story of that Japan Air cargo that saw the twin cylinders flying in formation?
Well, it's you have to look at what happened that night. He reported seeing initially a light following him. It's interesting that the direction he was looking was directly at Jupiter, which happened to be at its brightest that night. But all the radar targets that were reported that night, the FAA itself in its report says was transponder clutter and scatter, and the Air Force as well. But what's interesting is two airplanes that night, a United Airlines aircraft and a C-130 that were in the area, were asked to be vectored slightly off their courses so they could view the aircraft that night. And both of them flew near the aircraft that night and didn't see any target, any aircraft around the 747.
Let John Callahan respond. John?
Well, if you looked at the videotape that we took, you could see that there's a target. Every time the Japanese pilot said there was target at 12 o'clock or 2 o'clock, that we had a primary hit there. Our own...
Well, the FAA doesn't agree with that, sir.
Well, that's... you know, the FAA doesn't want to control UFOs. The it's not there, you got to remember now, if you were flying today and you looked out the window as a pilot and you said, hey, who's at my altitude, the first thing the controller would think of is I got two together, and then he would say, can you tell me what kind of airplane it is? And you would say, yes, it looks like an F-105. And they would say, have you got some numbers you can give me off it, and we'll track that guy down and we'll fix him for good for being up there. And you would say, yeah, here's his tail number. Now, we can't do that with a UFO. When the pilot looked out there and he says, I have traffic out here, apparently the three Japanese pilots are also lying. It's funny that everybody that's involved...
I got to get a break, guys, but you're making a good point. We'll come back with our remaining moments. Just skim the surface. Don't go away.
Now, they saw the planets, I think Saturn, was it Saturn? Jupiter? Jupiter. And that the CIA considers Jupiter classified. And that I guess the FAA official was told never to talk about the planet Jupiter. So that's interesting.
Let's get a call. Los Angeles, hello.
Hello, good evening, Larry. How are you guys doing tonight?
Fine, quickly, go ahead.
What was the most recent sighting in the United States, and where was it, and who saw it?
Do we know, Fife?
O'Hare. It was O'Hare, United Airlines O'Hare, right over
O'Hare
the airport.
Airport.
Yeah, there's a lot of press about it.
Yeah.
United Airlines pilots, crew, maintenance people on the ground.
I actually talked to a couple of the United Airlines personnel, and privately they admitted what they saw. It was a disc-shaped object, broad daylight, punched a hole through the clouds when it left. Mm-hmm. But they would not go on the record because they were debriefed by United Airlines, and that United Airlines said they would lose their job.
I remember it was headlines in the national news when it occurred.
James, they would have no point in lying, would they?
Are you you're asking me?
Yeah, why would the military officers, why would they lie?
Oh, I don't question that military officers are lying. I just doubt whether they're accurately seeing and reporting what they're seeing. And there are many, very easy to be fooled.
Yeah. All right, we've run out of time, but I thank you all very